spill has always been a very important part of what we do. We've just progressed to a point now where we spill at all 8 dams on the lower Columbia and Snake Rivers 24 hours a day.
This new biological opinion has survival performance standards. It's 96% for spring migrating fish, that would be yearling Chinook and steelhead, and 93% for sub-yearling Chinook. The studies we've done in the past few years show us being above that 96% for yearling Chinook and steelhead, and since we've made the improvements to the spillway here, we think we're right there at the 93% for sub-yearling Chinook.
We have an extensive monitoring program that helps us tailor our spill program to the needs of the fish. We're constantly monitoring conditions in the river and fish numbers in the river. And we mix the transportation and the spill programs together to get that optimal return of adults returning back to the system each year.
You know, in the past decade, we've really increased our knowledge on how spill affects fish passage and how it's related to the other parts of the dam. Every dam is different because each spillway is different. I mean, think of these three lower dams. Bonneville, the spillway is kind of in its own channel. The Dalles, the spillway is at a right degree angle to the powerhouse. And John Day, it's one big long dam with the powerhouse on one side and the spillway on the other. And you got to look at the dam holistically and match your spill to what you're trying to do with the rest of the project. Look at fish passage through all routes and how your spill and powerhouse operation affects that.
So there's this misconception out there that our program for fish doesn't include spill, which just isn't true. We're actually spilling 30 to 60% of the river 24 hours a day from the beginning of April all the way through the end of August. The vast majority of that time, the biological opinion calls for exactly what the court has ordered since 2005. As an example of this, the graph that you see now from Lower Granite Dam in 2009 shows the court-ordered spill as a solid black line. When we lay our biop spill on top of that with a yellow dashed line, you can see the only differences are in the middle of May and then again towards the end of August. We'd like to shut off spill for 2 weeks to maximize the number of fish that we are able to put on barges and transport past the hydro system. Our science has shown us that that is the opportune time where you get the most adults back compared to if you have left them in river. When you lay the fish passage graph on top of that, which is your solid blue line that you see now, you can see the reason why we shut off spill at the end of August is due to very low fish passage numbers. By that period of the run, almost the entire population of fall Chinook has already passed the dams. During the Snake River fall Chinook migration, over 1 million juvenile fish heading downstream passed Lower Granite Dam on the way out to the ocean. Last June, the average number of fish passing the dam each day was over 25,000. So by August, if we're only seeing 300 juvenile fish each day, we can be pretty confident that the vast majority of the run has passed. The actual date of when the trigger criteria have been met is going to vary from year to year. In the case when spill is shut off on the Snake River, if fish numbers increase to over 500 fish for 2 days, we will turn spill back on until the 300 fish trigger is met again. And it's also important to remember that the 300 fish spill curtailment trigger only applies to the four lower Snake River dams. Spill continues through August 31st on the four lower Columbia River dams in all cases, just like in the court order. In both places where we're proposing something different than the court-ordered spill, we will consult with the region and look at the biological factors before we change the operation. Prior to each spill season, we will look at our options for those 2 weeks in May, considering new research to determine the best operation for fish. Because of spill and structural improvements at the dams, juvenile fish survival through all 8 dams on the Lower Snake and Columbia Rivers is as good as, or better than it was when there were only 4 federal dams on the Columbia River. We worked with states and tribes for more than 2 years to come to an agreement on the spill program, and we continue to work together to make improvements all the time. So there really is broad agreement in the region that this is the best program for fish.
Spill is a very important method of passing fish through our dams, and we've been working hard to make sure that we're doing it the best we can. But more spill isn't always the answer. It's really optimizing how you spill to get the safest, best fish passage at your dam.
Spill provides a way to move fish quickly and safely, so we use it as one of the cornerstones of our program in the 2008 buyout. And that helps us combine with the other H's of habitat improvements, harvest, hatchery practices, all of that combines together to help us provide that package in the 2008 buyout.